smile. So much of life ahead. We'll find a place where there's room to grow.
And yes, we've just begun.
tahay mudanayaal imir weyn weli waxaynu bixinaynaa abaalmarintii kala duwaneed ay soo diyaarisay masxafka hidaha iyo dhaqanka Soomaaliyeed. Haatanna waxa aynu jaleecaynaa dhinaca baraha bulshada, fariimaha wanaagsan ama wacyigelinta dadka iyaguna ku guuleystay. Dad badan ayaa wacyigelin ka wada.
Minneapolis here is frankly starting to look like a war zone with all of the fencing that has been put up, the barbed wire, the road closures, and the city is warning residents that things might look very different here over the next couple weeks.
This is about maintaining safety and security.
Deputy Police Chief Eric Forrest says they're also planning to fortify the police precincts and other city infrastructure. Residents may also see National Guard soldiers out in the community doing security checks before the trial.
Providing patrol and presence and deterrence, really, in key business corridors.
For business owners, the city has new guidance online for hiring security companies and boarding up windows and doors.
We've been encouraged to have businesses check in with their insurance companies about their policies, and not simply to see if their policies are up to date, but to really go into the policies and what is covered.
For residents, the city is planning to host weekly meetings with representatives from all 70 of the city's neighborhood associations.
Influencers on social media are a big deal these days when it comes to companies partnering with people to promote their products. And leaders with the city of Minneapolis are looking to do the same, partnering with 6 local social media influencers to use their platforms to combat misinformation during the trial of former Minneapolis police officer Derek Chauvin.
What do you think the message is going to be? It's going to probably be pro-city. It's going to be anti-protest.
The city council says their goal with hiring these influencers is to reach people who do not normally watch the news or do not speak English. The council hasn't finalized how they're going to choose these influencers, but says they will base their decisions on recommendations from Minneapolis neighborhood groups and leaders.
It really reflects the fact that they know there's very little trust between community and city institutions. And that's real. Let's be honest about that. That's real.
Sarah Davis is the executive director of the Legal Rights Center in Minneapolis. Her firm plans to offer legal expertise and Q&As during the trial.
So what we're really trying to do is help folks understand what they're going to be seeing, answer questions about that.
While Morrison's social media following could make him a candidate for this new city position, he plans to remain an independent resource during the trial.
I don't think that they'll reach out to me. I hope they don't, because I don't want them to waste their time.
During the trial, most of the Hennepin County Government Center will be closed off to the public, but the city is setting up 2 demonstration zones where people can safely gather to protest. Those 2 zones will be located on the north and south sides of the Government Center Plaza.
While the damage caused by the riots last summer can still be seen across the city, Mayor Jacob Frey says this time around, they've had plenty of time to prepare.
It allows us to have the proper deployment. It allows us to have the proper, community engagement teams set up. The time that we have now makes this an entirely different equation.
But no matter how much they plan and prepare for this trial, city leaders say that this is kind of uncharted territory, and they will keep us updated as things change in the coming weeks, and we will keep you updated with all of those changes and all the information that we receive here in downtown Minneapolis. Gordon Severson, Carol Evan News.
The nominees for the 2020 Social Media Influencer of the Year: Mukhtar Sharif, Ilmi Iyosub, Ahmed Smiley, Marian Abdi, Fartoon Duvet, Anwar Iyohawa.
Abaalmarinta ugu sareysa caawa ee dhinaca baraha bulshada waxaa ku guuleystay oo madxafka hidaha iyo dhaqanka Soomaaliyeed
uu gartay in uu noqdo shakhsiga sanadka Mukhtar Sharif.
The city says that the six influencers will use their social media to intentionally target Black, Native American, Somali, Hmong, and Latinx communities with their messaging during the trial. We're told each one will be paid a flat fee of $2,000.
And yes, we've just begun.